Hi, my name is Adrian Ritter and I'm pastor here at Cove Presbyterian Church. I'm so glad you called our prayer line. Before we have a word of prayer together, though, I'd like to share with you some scripture and a devotion I wrote. The scripture passage comes from the 17th chapter of Acts. Then Paul stood in front of the Areopagus and said, "Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found among them an altar with the inscription, 'To an unknown God.' What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you. The God who made the world and everything in it, he who is Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands as though he needed anything, since he himself gives to all mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor he made all nations to inhabit the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of the places where they would live, so that they could and would search for God and perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as even some of your own poets have said, 'For we too are his offspring.' Since we are God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed. And of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead." And here's a devotion that I entitled, "Sharing Grace." In this little passage, I think Paul offers a wonderful example of sharing grace. And I'll tell you, I think it's a lesson most of us can apply. You see, often Christians spend more time condemning those outside the faith than inviting them to believe in the one who loved them before he laid the foundation of the universe. It's as though their top priority is to argue folks into recognizing that their intellectual ideas about God are wrong, rather than helping them understand that trusting him can actually focus and enhance the sense of the divine they may already have. In other words, there are many within the faith who seem to believe that God wants them to scare and to argue people into his kingdom. And I'll tell you, that may explain why so many of these otherwise sincere believers are ultimately unsuccessful in sharing God's love. And I think that's why we need to consider how Paul shared grace with the Athenians. You see, even though they were accustomed to debating, he didn't resort to intellectual proofs, nor did he condemn their pagan spirituality. As a matter of fact, he used their sense of the divine to provide a connection to the good news he was about to share. In other words, instead of being confrontational, Paul was inviting. And I'll tell you, we'd be wise to follow his example. Let's have a word of prayer. Lord God, be with the caller. Give him comfort and support and hope. In the name of Christ, amen. I'm so glad you called. I'd love to visit with you. If you're ever in the neighborhood, that's 3404 Main Street here in Weirton. Come on by Cove and we'll have a visit. Plus, if you're around here Sunday morning, 11 o'clock, we'd love to have you in worship. And don't forget to bring the kids. We got a wonderful children's program. And so until I talk with you again, I want you to remember, you're a child of God. And God loves you very much. Goodbye.